Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the most epic map generator tutorial ever. It's me, the one and only.
Thank you.
So here we are. After many requests from people to ask me if I wanted to make a tutorial how I make the maps, here we are. I'm gonna make a tutorial. I want to apologize for my shitty English. For some reason it's really hard to talk while I'm recording. I don't know, like normally I can easily talk, but for some reason it's strange to talk to yourself, you know, like I don't know, I'm not used to it. I'm not like schizophrenic or whatever, so yeah, that's that. So please bear that in mind. Okay, first of all, Photoshop. You need Photoshop. Don't use paint.net because it will compress your pictures and that will end up in an end result with blocks on it, which will kind of resemble Minecraft. So unless you want to have a server which resembles Minecraft, I wouldn't recommend doing it. So, use Photoshop. Second of all, go to this website. Not this one, but this one. Terrain.party. This is basically a website with all of the world in a little box and you can drag it over wherever you want and you will generate a height map. For example, you drag it over to here. You can scale it up, scale it down and download it. But the downside of this is that it's only 60 by 60 kilometers. So if you want to create a country or whatever, you're basically because you are not able to do that. But I am convinced that there are a lot of other software, internet sites, pictures, whatever that you can use if you really want to have like a picture of England or whatever, because I use that for my England map as well. Like I searched for a height map of Britain. But for now, we will use this and just click on download. But I already did that. I already downloaded it. So here we go. We have our map here, which is a zip file. Just extract it like that. And here we go. We have four pictures and a README file. Basically, the README file is like a bunch of text which explains all the different pictures and what it is and blah blah blah. If you're interested in that, you can use it. But I'm not really interested in it. So, we have like four pictures which go from really detailed to less detailed. What we are gonna use is the merge one, which is like this one, which is like a mix between detailed and not very detailed. There we go. So, let's open it in Photoshop. One and here we go, we are done, we have our map. No, I'm joking, like there's a lot of work to be done. But I mean, we have our map here, which is basically a mountain and low area over here, because the white areas are high and the black areas are low. Next step, very important, rescale your picture to 1533 by 1533. There we go. You need this size so the generator is able to generate the map, because the map is 3 by 3 kilometers and it's like 1533 by 1533. Don't ask me why, it's the way it is. So here we go, we are done. Okay, I don't know how many times I'm gonna say that, we are not done. Basically what we want is to make a map that resembles a country, right? So, and we didn't find any height map that resembled a country. But how can we fix that? Well, we are going to Google Maps and search for a map that we want. Let's say we want Italy. So there we go. I'm gonna make a print screen, open paint, Ctrl V, Ctrl S, call it Italy. Yeah, and open it in Photoshop. See, it should be here. As you can see, like I'm really chaotic I'm really chaotic. Like you can. Never mind. Don't look at that. It's fine. You can trust me. But here we go. Italy. Control A. Drag it to this map. Scale it a little bit so it kind of fits. So let's say we want it like this, right? Click OK. And there we go. Let's unlock this. But we need to scale this down to like 30-40%, so we can still see kind of the outlines, but not everything. And we're going to make a new layer, which is going to be white. Put this down here. And there we go, we can see everything. So we can just do it like this. Get our brush. And paint all the stuff. And there we go. It doesn't have to be that detailed, you will see later why. But we can turn this layer off. Control click on it. Or not control click, control A. Alt click. And there we go, we have a selection of our map. So let's turn this one off as well. And you can see here, we have this selection. If we click on this first layer, click on this button over here. I need to turn the selection around. Here we go, we have our map of Italy. And a little bit of Croatia, Corsica. Beautiful, right? Now let's create a new layer, which is going to be black. Oh, black. Because the color of the sea is black. So if we put this here, we have our map, we have our sea, we have our landmass, we have our little islands. Beautiful, right? Be proud of yourself, you made this. You need to cherish it like a child, you know? So right now we want to add some mountains and some rivers and some crazy landmarks, right? We want to make the map unique. But before we're gonna do that, we are going to press Ctrl L and scale down the light. Like that. So, what we're gonna do is take a brush and set up this. Click like a random spot, like this color is good because we have like this bright white spot here. We don't want that. Let's put down a bit. We don't want this bright spot because otherwise we will have a mountain right there. So you can kind of search for some spots that are really bright and dim them down a bit. Yeah, I guess we're good. But we want to have mountains, right? I mean, a map needs mountains. You need the resources, you need the cool look of it. So, what are we gonna do? We are going to open. We're gonna open a mountain. This. I already downloaded it from a website. I mean, you can just go to Google, type in like mountain height map, whatever. You will find a picture like this. So, we're gonna. Let's say we want to have. This piece, this will be one mountain. Let's drag it into our project. Place it somewhere around here. I'll drag it out a bit because it needs to resemble Alps because the Alps are in the north, right? And click. Okay, we do that. No, we're not. Edges. Edges are the worst thing in making a map. We want to have all edges smooth because right now if we want to generate this, it will basically mean that this will be like a 90 degree cliff. We don't want that. So what are we gonna do? We are going to merge this layer. Yeah, so click our clone stamp into alt click and go over it. Like that. Looks good. I mean, you can also change the shape of it, like if you want to have like some way into the mountain. Just do it like this. Like right now you would have a mountain with a way in, so people can build there or whatever if they wish to. And there we go. We have our first mountain. However, we want to add some more mountains. So let's go back to here. Let's switch this to not like this one. Drag this into the picture. Let's put a mountain on Croatia. Okay. Again, merge it. The clone stamp tool. Go. Merge it into the picture. So we don't have any edges, so the end result will look great. Like, you need to imagine every little edge on your map. Like this, see this map? You can barely see it, but on the end result you will see it. So every edge needs to be gone. Now we have a mountain here, which will go like this. Plop. Maybe we want to change it a bit. Make a passageway through here. So we have a mountain here, and passageway. And it's as easy as that. We have a mountain here. Now we only need a mountain in the south. So let's grab this one and drag it in again. Scale it down. Okay, merge it. Clone stamping tool. And go across edges. We have three mountains, but we are not done yet. Hell no, we're far from done. We need to make shorelines. So how are we gonna make that? I mean, we want to have a beach which goes slightly up into grassland, right? So we need to smoothen this out. We can do that by using the clone stamp or the brush. It's up to you. I mean, you can use the brush as well. The edges, which will take some time, so I'm gonna speed this up for you guys. And there we go. I mean, normally if you would do this legit, you would take way more time to get some nice edges and things like that. There is also another way to do it, which is with the clone stamp tool. You can put like this value lower or higher and just go you see it creates this smooth edge on sight. It's up to you, like what way you want to do it. You can use the clone stamp or the brush. It really depends on situation. Mostly I do it both, actually. If I want to make a really good map, I would take a lot of time to get all of these edges really correctly, really smooth, so it looks really professional, like there are no strange cliffs or whatever on the edge. We're fine. So here we have it. We have our mountains, we have our country, we have the sea, we have the islands. We have apparently not confirmed yet smooth edges, but right now imagine you want to add some rivers to it. So let's take your brush, put it to 100, alt click on the sea. Let's say we want the river here. For example, we want to have like a north or south thing, and you want to have it kind of a border in between, like a land border. You can easily do that. Oh, let's push the brush bigger. You can usually do that by just like this, create like a little river that floats in between. And done. No, hell no, we need to move the edges. So let's put this a bit back, put this a bit up, and let's go across the river. Let's move it up. And we have a river. So let's say, what do we want more? Let's say we want to add in a custom logo, whatever. Why not? Let's open it, go to pictures, go to my chaotic map, and try and search logo. Let's say you want to add I don't know, maybe an eagle. Why not? Ctrl A, drag it in, let's put it somewhere in the corner there, or maybe even in the middle. Like that would be cool as well. Like it's Rome, right? So Rome would be here. So let's keep it down, let's put it right there. What we can do now is get a color, it's kind of a beach color, just like this shape here. Put it in. But important, scale up the size to, let's say, 1 or 2. 2? Yeah, 2 pixels. No, one person. Because otherwise, if you fill it in, you will have like edges. So let's fill it in like that. And there you go, we have our logo. So this will be beach. But if we want to have the area around it kind of smooth, like it would go from land to beach, we need to kind of smooth this out as well. So let's go here, let's put it to dark, put the capacity to 14. Something like that. And we will have a logo right there. So I think we are actually done to try and test it out, like if it's going to work. So let's save it as a PNG, call it Super Ultra Deluxe Best Map Ever Made Ever. Save it. Okay. And now we need to go to TerraTool. So the thing is, you go to TerraTool, you need to log in. There you go, you log in, you see all my things that I have done, but this is not my only account. I have like 6 accounts to do it, because you will find out that you need to do a map over and over again. Because the only way how you're going to see results is to generate. Which we're gonna do now. I mostly set it to 185, I don't know, right? I think it's the best height. Ultra map deluxe. Ultra map deluxe. Yeah, that sounds good. Select your map. You can click random dispersion or slow pace, it depends on you. Random dispersion basically put trees randomly all over the map, and slow pace will put trees based on the angle of the slope. So let's generate it. It will take about like 4 to 5 minutes or something. So I'm gonna hold here and wait for it to finish, and I will be back to you soon. And there we go, it's finished. This is the moment of truth. This is the moment where you will see if you fucked up or not. So let's click OK. And as you can see, we kind of fucked up. I mean, it's good-ish. You can see here that the edges are not good enough. Like, it's not smooth enough. For the rest, I mean, the logo looks good, the mountain looks good. This is an easy fix. Basically, you can never have it good in the first try. Like, normally, it would take me about like 15 tries to actually have it perfect as I wanted. So, let's go back now. We can use this as a reference and look like what we did wrong. We can see here that these are all cliffs. Why? Because this is way too steep. So how are we gonna fix that? Easy. Lots of fly, ignite our bones. When they strike, we light up the world. Like firestorm. When they strike, feel the love. Lots of fly, ignite our bones. When they strike. Okay, so after 3 tries, this came out. I mean, if I go on like this, we can make it perfect, but it will take way too long. You get the idea of it. Eventually, it will be as you like, and it will be done. Like, if you want to have it really perfect, it will be like 10 to 15 tries or something, because it's really random. Like, you can only see the results when you generate it. But I'm pretty happy with this map, actually. I mean, the design of it, if I would go on to, I would smoothen out the edges more and make it more beautiful. But I mean, when I first tried to make maps, we just did what we thought was cool. Like, after many tries and many fails, we figured out kind of a way how to do it. So I hope with this video, like, some people that watch this will have an easier time to actually create a map. I mean, you can do whatever you want, as long as you take the time for it. Like, the easy part is just the design of it. The hard part is actually the edges, as you can see. Like, it's only the edges that you try to have smooth, right? So that's why you do all these generators of the map, like 10 times or whatever. But the design itself, we already had it from the start, but... Yeah, I hope you guys had something about it, and I'm sorry for my shit English. Like, normally I talk better, but it's kind of hard to actually explain it on a video. This is the first video I have done like this, so good luck, and I hope to see some extra maps soon. See ya.